Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. In this tutorial, we're going to edit the wall and assign different names to the wall so that we can control the model and appearance of the model. Go to the project browser and double click the foundation view. Now select this wall, click the edit type. Go to duplicate and rename this wall to foundation generic 8 inches. Click OK. Click the edit structure and go to the bottom and select, click the insert button. Click it twice. Now you have inserted new layers of the new layer into the foundation wall. Select the number 2 row, the structural one, and click the move up button once. Select the structural, this wall, and select the move down button one. Make sure that the core boundary layer above is above the structural wall, which is the 8 inches, and the core boundary layer below is below this wall. Click this in this input, click the down arrow and select the finish one, then click on this input and select the finish two. Change the value to 1/2 inch. Change this value to 1/2 inch. Click OK. Click to return to the drawing. Click on the view detail and change it to fine. Now when you zoom in close, you see the difference. You see the two different layers that I added recently. Go to the quick access toolbar, click the thin line button to see the thickness of the wall. Then I'm going to click it again. Now use a window selection to select all the wall in this model. Click the filter button, check none, and check the wall. Click OK. In the property palette, change the location line to core center line. Move into the drawing. Click out. Now select this wall, the basic foundation generic 8 inches. Use a window selection to select all the wall in the model in the foundation view, except the two short walls, the four short walls, these two on the right and these two at the bottom. Now go to the filter panel, check none, check wall, click OK. And because now we have selected different walls, you see basic wall, multiple type selected. Click the down arrow and select the basic wall foundation generic 8 inches. Now all the changes has been updated to this model. Click outside to end the command. Select this wall, edit type, and click duplicate. Rename this to foundation generic 6 inches. Click OK, click edit, click insert twice, then select this and click the move up twice. Select this other layer and click the move down twice. Now change the value to 0.5 inches. Change the value to 0.5 inches or 1/2 inch. Click OK. Click OK to close the figure. This updates this foundation wall. Now go to the property palette and select the match property. Select this wall and select this wall. This wall this one. Click the modify button. Go to the ground floor plan view. Select this wall. In the property palette, click the edit type button. Click duplicate. Rename this wall to my external wall. My external wall generates 6 inches. Click OK. Click the edit structure. Click the insert twice. Select this input and click the move up twice. Select this row and click the move down twice. Change the value to 1/2 inch. Change this value to 1/2 inch. Click OK. Click OK. Select this wall. Go to the property palette and click edit type. Click duplicate. Rename this wall to my internal generic 6 inches. Click OK. Click the edit structure. Click the insert button twice. Select the row, number 3 row, and click the move up button twice. Select the number 3 row and click the move down button twice. Change the value to 1/2 inch. And change this value to 1/2 inch. Click OK. Click OK. Change the view details to fine. Select this wall. I'm going to select the internal, my internal wall, and click the edit material. Click the edit structure. Click the material by category. Click the down arrow and select painting. Select this material and click OK. Click on the same material, click on the by category material and select the material packing strip and click OK. Click OK. Click OK to return to the project. Now you cannot see the effect on this view. If I go to 3D view, you see the changes through the transparent window. Now I'm going to close this view and select this wall. Click the edit type, edit structure, click on this structural material. This is the internal part of this wall, so I want to use the same material and click OK. Then click this. I'm going to select different material because this is the external part of the wall. Scroll down. I'm going to select the gypsum wall board and click OK. Click OK. Click OK to return to the project. Click the default 3D view to see the results. Change the view to realistic. Alright, now the material is displayed. So I'm going to close this view by clicking the X button. Select this wall again. I want to see the difference in the floor plan. To do that, I need to assign another different material into this. So I'm going to click the edit type, edit, click the structural material and scroll down. Select the concrete light width and change the cut pattern to select the diagonal down and click OK. Click OK. Click OK to return to the project. Now you see, you can tell the difference between the external wall and the internal wall. Now use a window selection. Click the filter button, check none, and check the walls. Click OK. Make sure that you change the location line to core center line. Click OK. go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property command. Select this as the source object. Click this wall, this wall, this wall, this wall. Click the unjoin. Select this wall. This wall. This wall. This wall. Make sure that you click all the external walls. Press escape to get out of the command. This is my internal wall. So go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. Select this wall and click the internal walls. Unjoin. This wall. This wall. Click the modify button. Click the split element to split this wall. Click the chart. Go to the match property and select this wall. Match it to this wall. Select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall. Select the trim extend single element. Select this face and extend this wall. Go to the default 3D view to see the results. Now you see some of the walls at the bottom went in the wrong direction. We'll take care of this problem in a minute. Close, click the export into close. This wall, click the flip arrow to flip it outside. This wall, click the flip arrow. 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 Click the flip arrow. Go to the default 3D view to see the result. Now we need to flip this wall again. Close this view. Select this wall and flip it outside. Select the default 3D view. Now go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. Select this wall and click this wall. This wall. This wall. Now select the roof, click the sunglasses, hide vertical, select this beam, hold down the control key, select this beam, this beam, this beam, this beam, click the down arrow, and select my external wall 6 inches. Go to the file tab, hover the mouse cursor to save as and select project. Rename this file to 00_019_DIAB_I and click the save button. Alright, we'll continue to model our wall and flip them in the right direction in the next tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.